us are patrolling the streets. Got to stay out of sight. There's a piece of flint in the pouch. It's a striker to start a fire. Each Mongol soldier had to be self-sufficient.
God is testing me. I've scavenged weapons and tools enough to survive. The Khan once demanded I learn to draw a bow and fight like one of his soldiers, and I am grateful for that. He gave me his own arrows, made for punching holes in armor. The ice around me provides all I need to drink, but it runs red with blood. The Prophet's army now patrols a dead city. These are not the soldiers who first met us at the city gates. They've been changed somehow. Among them, I can see a man that I myself killed in the battle. The old legends say that those who looked upon the divine source relinquished their very souls to it, attaining immortality. If this is true, I will surely perish here, buried with the secret I was sent to find.
Those banners, the insignia of the Deathless Army. These are spurs from Mongol horsemen. They're far more decorative and lavish than I'd expect. But they're still well used. Whoever owned them was wealthy, but they rode with the army. They're stables. Nothing but bones, picked clean. blue glass vase. Still in excellent condition. Not many of these survived, for obvious reasons. Ruins under the water. Need to provide the spark. Demonic possession. They were performing.
Deep below the holy ground of our city, we have found the source of the corruption. One of Hell's winding tunnels snakes up and vomits forth a miasma of evil. There is no pattern to the demon's depredations, but his mark is plain. Men driven to wicked words and acts, as God's grace is driven from them. We take them here to the mouth of Hell itself to drive out the demons. We do not always succeed. Often the poor wretches are too far gone and they die when we drive the beasts out of them. It is heartbreaking to lose good people, but we must stand against the devil in all his forms.
Exorcisms. No way to open that gate. Must be some way of breaking through. They believe this cavern was a gate to hell. Holding it down. No telling how many people died.
My mind is clear today. It was not so yesterday, and it will not be again. They say the devil is inside me. They say I am possessed. I have seen the beast in my heart, and it is only me, only my broken mind. But the priests will not listen. I cannot blame them. Some days they appear to me as apparitions of manifest pain and hatred. So clouded are my eyes. I spit and yowl, for I am mad. But I know there is no evil in my heart, only sickness that no man can cure.
Demonic possession. They were performing exorcisms. Should be high enough. That looks about right. Let's see if it works. Thank you. for Greek fire. Iron pendant. Soldiers in the Empire would sometimes tie them to their belts.
Must have fallen asleep. It is hard to tell time beneath the ice. The deathless ones had been busy. Where a pile of ashes smoldered the night before, a corpse now lay, skin as milky white as a dead fish. As I watched, the dead man breathed, a clicking death rattle in reverse, as he sucked air in for the first time in a day. Then he looked at me. And I recognized him at last. I killed this man once before during the battle, and he has not forgotten. So I killed him again, crushed his new skull before he could stand, but his ashes smolder anew. I will not be here when he awakes. The cold look in his eyes was like a promise. Like the phoenix, he will rise again and again, each time more determined to end my life. If I stay, sooner or later he will succeed.
Ugh!
At last, I killed one of the deathless soldiers. I tracked him through the day until he was alone. He seemed to sense me before I struck, as if he knew the sound of my bowstring. He was strong, but I am clever and I have faith. My arrows pierced his flesh, but he fought on until I placed a shot between his eyes. Even then, he managed to wound me before I caved in his skull. His body caught fire and fell into ash before my eyes. It has been hours since he died, but his ashes still smolder, hissing and popping in the darkness. I do not believe this is his end. The source has a great and terrible sway over those it touches. I must know what happens next.
Mongolian script. It together. An ancient carving of a pagan god. Perhaps a fertility idol. It's thousands of years old. behind that barrier. Mongolian script. I can't quite piece it together. Valentinus, the timekeeper.
After the city was built, the first generation of followers stared out upon it. One among them, a man named Valentinus, has spent his whole life devoted to the study of time and its passage. The prophet sought him out in the crowd and asked him what he thought of the city. Valentinus said he felt it was a blessed place, that time would move slowly there, and that Katesh would last for generations untold. The prophet smiled, for he knew that he had made a home where his people might be safe.
Maybe I could use them to break through that gate. break down that gate. Now to fire. That did it.
Before I even held you, I almost lost you, Lara. Yet you fought back, determined to live, breathe, ball your tiny fists and scream the hospital down. It was the best noise I ever heard. When I went home that snowy night, I cooked myself a steak. Then I drank half a bottle of whiskey, tried to make snowshoes out of tennis rackets, and fell asleep with the cat. I was so damn happy.
I think I must have heard that story about a dozen times, and I could hear it a dozen more. I wish that could have lasted. I wish we'd had more time.